What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the MoreMobHeads Minecraft plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. If you didn't know, you actually have the option to use head blocks in the game, but they do lack quite a bit of variation in your options. If you like this aspect and you're looking to add more options to your game, then the MoreMobHeads plugin is what you need. This is primarily used for decoration, as there are small blocks builders can use to add detail, or if you're in a PvP server, it can be a way to show off popular players that you might have defeated. Head to MoreMobHeads on Spigot and press download now, and then save this file somewhere easily accessible to use in just a minute. Head towards your Apex server panel, stop the server, and then make sure you're running a plugin compatible version like Paper or Spigot. And after that, you can click FTP file access near the top left. Log in and then head towards the plugins directory, and from here you can press upload in the top left corner, and on the next page, drag the new file into the upload area. Once it reaches 100%, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. When you enter, the gameplay itself isn't going to look any different since this plugin is obtained through commands or through killing other mobs or users. The first task you'll want to do is try killing another player, as this will have a 50% chance to drop their head. Or you can try killing a mob for a lower chance to obtain their skull. These will drop just like any other item, but the looting enchantment does help improve its rate. You can also change this rate in the configuration file, which can manage how often players are able to get them. Alternatively, blockheads can be obtained and spawned into the world for decoration. These can be traded by wandering traders with custom heads that any lucky player can get. Using them in your base or other structures can bring it to life, and it's a great way to spruce up your world spawn or hub. As for the custom trades, they take emeralds or sometimes unique blocks to get the heads. This is the only way for default players to obtain these items, though of course it can be configured. Either way, each trader provides more than enough items, as you can get 8 out of 1 block and emerald. This makes it so much easier to collect and build a stash of them, which could be traded among other players. The most important aspect to MoreMobHeads is its settings, since these control the head drop chance, blacklisted mobs and worlds, custom trades, and more. We're going to be focusing on the config file, but definitely check out the other files as well to see what can be changed. Head towards your FTP file access from your server panel, and then log in and enter into the plugins directory. From here, enter into MoreMobHeads and find the config YML file, and once you find that, click edit to the far right to start making changes. When you're done editing the file, click save at the top, and then return to the main panel and restart the server to apply the changes. Before you use any MoreMobHead commands, you're going to need to install luck perms or another permission node manager. Normally, server operators are able to run all of the commands, but this setup is a little bit different, and even a server operator is going to need the permissions. If you're unable to use commands, this is going to be the most popular issue, since there's no way to run its commands unless you set up a permission system. This is mainly done through luck perms, but there are other plugins to accomplish the same thing. If your plugin isn't loading, check that you're running a version on your server that matches the plugin that you downloaded. Of course, you'll also want to make sure it was placed inside of the plugins folder in the FTP file access. This plugin really doesn't change the gameplay at all, but it's a nice decorative addition to allow your players to create, trade, or loot them from other players, and it's a good way to set your server apart from others. That's all for this one, and as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.